Hi, welcome to a video on using the first and the second derivative to determine characteristics of a function. So with this problem, we're given this function f of x, and we're going to try to determine where this function is increasing, decreasing, and the concavity of it, as well as inflection points. So we're going to start by getting the first derivative. So that's just a real easy power rule here. We're going to start with the x cubed, so that's 3x squared. Here 3 times 2 is 6x, and then minus 9. So there's our first derivative. Second derivative, do our derivative of our first derivative, so 6x plus 6. So once we have our derivatives, we can use those to identify areas of increasing, decreasing, and so on. So for increasing and decreasing, for these two here, we use our first derivative. Now when we go and do our concave up and concave down, that's when we're going to use our second derivative. Okay, so for the increasing, first I need to find where is this first derivative actually equal to zero. So let's take our first derivative, 3x squared plus 6x minus 9. Let's put it equal to 0 and solve for what would be called the critical points. I'm going to divide everything by 3 and make my numbers a little smaller here. So dividing by 3 doesn't affect anything because I divide 0 by 3 and that's still 0. Factoring this, let's do a little factoring. That's going to give me factors of plus 3. Minus 1, and again, if that's too fast, just pause the video, catch up there. Setting my factors equal to 0, I get critical points of negative 3 and positive 1. So these are the x values where that first derivative is equal to 0. So I'm going to make myself a little number line here. I'm going to make a number line and put on this number line my critical points, my negative 3 and my 1. Now sometimes instead of a number line, people will use like a chart. I just prefer a little number line. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to test values on each side and in between my critical values and see whether the derivative is positive or negative. So if I pick, for example, a value in between negative 3 and 1, like an easy x value here would be just to pick x as 0. And plug that 0 into the first derivative and figure out what value I get, whether I get a positive or negative. So if you plug 0 into that first derivative, to the first derivative at 0, you're going to get a negative value. So that negative value, I'm going to put that on the number line like this. This is negative. What that tells me is that when the derivative is negative, that means the slope's negative. It means my function is going to be decreasing in that little section there. Let me make that a little better. That's decreasing. All right, so I keep going. I pick a point on either side of 1 and of negative 3. If you pick a point on the side of 1, like say you pick the value of 2, you plug it in the derivative, you're going to find that the values are positive for that derivative. And the same if you pick a value over here, maybe you pick like negative 4, and you plug that into your derivative, you're going to find again you get positive values there. So what we have is we have this function with a positive derivative, so it means it's going up, and over here it'll be going up. So you can sort of see where the function is increasing and decreasing. So I just need to sort of give that information in an interval form here. So where's the function increasing? Alright, so the function is going to be increasing if I look at that number line from negative infinity until I get up here to negative 3, unioned with starting at 1 and off to infinity. So again, my number line, sorry, it's kind of squeezing off the side here, shows you the increasing. Now the decreasing is in between the negative 3 and 1, so it's decreasing on the interval from negative 3 over here. One. All right, so that's increasing and decreasing. Now I'm going to pretty much do the same sort of procedure with the second derivative to figure out concave up and concave down. So to start with, I'm going to take my second derivative, which is 6x plus 6. I'm going to figure out where is that equal to 0 at. So my second derivative, if I solve that for x, I'm going to have 6x equals negative 6, or x equals negative 1. So my second derivative is going to be equal to 0 at negative 1. So again, I'm going to put a little number line here. I'm going to label this number line my second derivative. So any point that I pick and plug in, I'll plug it in the second derivative. So I'm going to pick a point on each side of negative 1, and I'm going to plug it in the second derivative. So on the right side of negative 1, I could easily pick 0. On the left side of negative 1, I could pick, say, negative 2. But any number on that side would be fine. So the second derivative, if you plug 0 into your second derivative, you're going to get 6, which is a positive value. And so if that's a positive value here, what that tells me, again, remember, this is second derivative, so it tells me that the graph is concave up, it's curving up like this. And then if I choose a negative 2, plug that into the second derivative, you're going to end up with a negative. So that means your second derivative is negative on that section, which means you've got a sad face, you're concave down there. Okay, so that gives me all the information so that I can state the intervals of the concave up and concave down. So we're concave up beginning at negative 1 and carrying to infinity. We are concave down from negative infinity until we get to negative 1. So there's our concavity. Okay, well, one last thing. State the ordered pair of any inflection points. Now, an inflection point is a point where the concavity changes. So I've got that. I've got that right here at negative 1. So it's a point where the concavity changes. So I know that has the x value of negative 1. Now, it says give the ordered pair. So the ordered pair would be the point x is negative 1, and then I need to get the y value. And then I can check it on a graph. So to get the y value, you have to plug that x value back into the function. You have to find f of negative 1. Don't plug it in the derivative. Plug negative 1 back into the original function. So go ahead and do that. Try that. Plug it back into that x cubed. Work it all out, and you should end up with a y value of 20. So we have an inflection point at negative 120. All right, so this answers all of these questions here, but let me also highlight some other things that this tells us about. So all these little grids and graphs, they give me kind of a lot of information. Like this first derivative number line that I see over here. I also know from this that we would have a maximum value at negative 3 and over here a minimum at 1. So if I were to look at the graph, I would see the peak at negative 3 and the min at 1. So that's actually what we're going to do. Do a quick little check here. So what I've done is I've put this into Desmos. So let me bring that up here. And we can see the graph and what we have found to be true here. So we see this section here where we're increasing. We see this section between negative 3 and 1 where we're decreasing. And again, a section here where we're increasing again. We can see our max point here. We can see our minimum point here. So you can see 120 is the inflection point. So the graph just confirms everything we found by doing those first and second derivative tests. All right, I hope this has been helpful.